commencing Atlas system suit initialization. Life support systems activated. Shield kinetic system online.
Now that is the portaliest voice I've heard for a while.
Scanner damaged. Repair required. Aerial propulsion jetpack online. Multi-tool and mining laser attachment operational.
I don't think I have control right now. I think we're doing like a kind of a cutscene.
User initialization sequence complete.
You discovered this place today at this time. That's not what time it is. I guess it is that time. Never mind. Didn't quite immediately match up. Alright, so a little choppiness already. And yep, I can see that FOV everyone's complaining about. So let's immediately try to fix that. That's not an options menu. There we go. Alright. Going to immediately try to fix some of this stuff. 75? Are you joking? Oh my god. I'm so happy I waited, just for that. I'll be less happy I waited if it turns out that the game doesn't run, because that'll obviously be a problem. Did it even change? It still looks the same. It didn't change. Okay. Is there a faster way to increase this than clicking a lot? Can I type it in? No, apparently not. Alright. Oh, it maxes out 100. That's convenient for me. Apply. 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 Nope. Okay. So the options menu doesn't work. That's a good start for a game. And chat, yeah, I read chat all the time, in every chat all the time. That happens, yes, but Jesus Christ, I can't respond to everybody always saying acknowledge me, acknowledge me, acknowledge me over and over again. It's not entertaining for anyone. Alright, so the menu doesn't work. That's interesting. So people are saying I have to hold it down. Is that really? Really? Oh wow, if I didn't know to look for it, I would have never noticed that the mouse was filling up for that. Did it change? It's a little hard to tell, to be honest. Yeah, I guess I'll have to trust it. It turned down all my settings to basically minimum. That's impressive, considering the lack. Maybe we'll turn off anti-aliasing, but turn on something. I don't know. Let's see if we can run it better a little bit. Ah, it's working right now. That's a good start. Hello. That's some draw. Ow. Okay, don't hurt yourself with jetpack, apparently. There's some draw Are we loading? There's suspicious stuff down there. So you have to keep in mind that apparently a jetpack can hurt you. There's a planet out there. The hitching is a bummer, but I've seen some really bad pop-in stuff in the past about this game, so I'm kind of surprised how well I seem to be able to see pretty far. Hello. So, if I want to upgrade my my cooling, I want to need all those things. Thamium 9, Chrysonite and Gravitino Ball. Oh, opened up a menu on accident. Thought the game froze. Tab is menu, apparently. Are these the things I'm trying to build right now? We need Karite Sheets. Pyridium. A few things. I mean, really, I should just pick a direction and start trying to grab things, right? If nothing works. Oh. Got one granite from our supply drop here. But we need a key card to access this thing. There we go. I think that's... That might be all we're getting from the starting base. Let's see. Teleport items from exosuit to starship at any time. Now it's gone. It's cool. Just in the middle of reading that thing. Alright. So we have a distress beacon. Reality seems to fold in on itself. One moment, I can see debris, in another, a vast red orb. Almost too large, and too bright to behold. It knows me, inside and out, more than I could ever know myself. Could this be the face of creation itself, or, in my hazy, freshly awakened state, am I being manipulated? A name burns itself into my mind. Atlas. And a request, made without words, that I should follow the path this being, this Atlas, has set for me. So, do I want to go around in random directions, or get some little guidance? I figure it's just fine to... I'll just take the guidance, because it's not gonna... I can't force me to do anything. I feel suffused with the warm glow of approval. I was lost, but now I am found. The Atlas acknowledges my allegiance, and then blah blah blah. Fine. Who needs press A to continue or voice acting? Let's just make text go away whenever it feels like it. I love when that happens. There we go. Hello. So we're on a cold planet, apparently, to start off. And this thing is giving me iron. But it's costing me mining beam. Alright, so what do I need for more mining beam? That's a good question, right? Let's see. They really do just dump you in. So, where is my mining beam? Pulse engine, thruster, photon cannon. Those are all the starship inventory. Exosuit separate. There we go. So, my weapon is... If hazard protection requires energy, zinc, titanium, or shielding shards to power that. Jetpack's not a high priority right now. Life support requires isotope elements. Okay. But where's my mining laser? Why is that? Multi-tool. There we go. Mining beam. It's powered with isotope elements. Okay, so... Just anything with a lightning icon on it then can be used to power it, apparently. We can repair our scanner with carbon. Okay. So, for life support and for our weapon, let's look for isotope elements. And we got iron, which does not appear to count as that. So we need to figure out exactly what isotope elements are. Oh, there we go. Tree. So, like any open world survival game, the first thing we do is knock down trees. That's the smart first move if you don't want to be a dead person. Might as well stock up on that first before we straight up die due to lack of life support or mining abilities to make more life support. There we go. We have 96 now. Interestingly, I don't think you have a jump. I think you just immediately jetpack. Like, the moment you press the space bar, you're already jetpacking. Oh. Oh, it's thermal protection on my suit. I thought it was my gun overheating. Is thermal protection the same thing as life energy? Hazard protection. 47%. Is that the same icon? Probably. Let's see. Protection from specific planetary conditions can be increased through installation of hazard protection units. So just, I assume this is what's protecting me against the cold. So we need zinc, titanium, and shielding shards. So we need metals. Yeah, it's still dropping. There it goes. That's a good sign. Incoming death. Alright. Zinc and titanium. That's iron. How am I gonna find zinc and titanium? Probably through some kind of mine. Iron. There's a lot of iron around here. I wonder if... Oh, there's a crystal over here. And a weird floating rock. That seems noteworthy. Kind of a cool starting planet. I don't know why they're sticking up at those angles. Hello, floating. Should I mine that? Oh. Hitching. I have a pretty good computer. So it's a bit of a bummer that this is happening. Silicate, cryocyte. Here we go. There's organic life around here. It's getting colder too. Oh, hello? You freaking out? What you doing? Hey. You want iron? You want iron, buddy? You like eating iron? You happy now? You gonna stop running around like a lunatic? He's just running in circles like a lunatic. Okay, yeah, that seems like a simulation of life. Okay, what is that? And then I'm gonna get the hell out of here, because I think we're in trouble. Yeah, I get it. Plutonium! I think this game may have a bit of a learning curve at the beginning, so we'll figure it out. There's a few things I need to figure out how to manipulate and how to move around. What's that? Iron. Always iron. I'm gonna head back to the ship. I think I can find it. Oh yeah, we have a waypoint to it. Because if I learned anything from the Martian, it's that being inside of the thing helps with the temperature problems. Come on. Come on. I'm about to die. Probably. Feathering it. There we go. So can I properly go inside a ship even though it's all busted? Hitching. Hitching hard. There we go. Alright, so, for our takeoff system we need carrier sheets. Still need to actually learn how to make those. Probably a little early for the game to be telling me how to take care of my inventory stuff. Oh. Hello. Alright, so, are we recharged immediately, or is this just the ship's systems, is what I wonder. So am I full up? No, bring up my... yeah, that's my head. Okay. That's a start. Alright, I guess we'll just head right back up there again. A little aimless right now. I do need to figure out how to actually recharge my gun. That's gonna be a problem really fast. Charge. Okay, so carbon, for example. Just like that? Alright, just like that. There we go. What are you? What are you? First of all, I don't know what the deal is with these guys, because these kinds of formations are normally supposed to be, like, from water spatter? Falling from a ceiling. There's no ceiling here. So, like, why would they consistently drop in one spot to create that kind of formation? The ringed ridges make me think that that's what it is. It's the, like, what you'd see in a cave. Which is why it looks really weird that it's just, not only is it not in a cave, but it's not sticking straight up and down. It's just kind of facing whatever direction it feels like. See, everything here is iron. I guess lucky day for all the people that live here. They all live off of iron, and everything's made of iron. What a coincidence. Here we go. I ended up in a completely different spot again. What is this formation? It just straight up looks like someone's mouth. It just looks like I'm walking into a nightmare mouth, and then I'm going to be consumed by this cliff. Okay. A lot of the same stuff. It'll take a little while to get past some of the visual noise, because there's a lot of different elements everywhere. Up. Here we go. Ah. Did this entire thing just freak out? Oh yeah, the entire thing violently shudders when you try to mine edit it. Oh, whoa. Hey. That's an enemy. And I'm under attack. Alright, that could have planned this better. Where'd you go? There you are. Oh, you're trying to warn people. Stop. Okay. It just, at the end it was just like, take me with you. And it just rammed into my face. Let's see. What milestone? Alright, well our inventory is full, so we're gonna wanna head back just for that at least. I will immediately admit that I'm a little overwhelmed right now. There's just a lot of elements to keep track of. I kind of wish that I could, like, put an on-screen HUD element, and maybe I can and I just don't know how yet. For, like, here's the thing you're trying to build. Put it on the screen, and it'll, like, be a reminder of, like, you need this much of these things to build the thing. But I think I might have to keep opening my interface for that. The interface is very Destiny, by the way. This whole situation, all the way down to having a grid of square-shaped icons on a translucent background with white borders, and the entire background all moves at the... It all moves at a pace based on how fast you're moving your mouse. Which I'm sure is probably extra design for joystick controls on the controller, where it probably has a much more exaggerated background movement to match the joystick. I need to not be dead, so I'm gonna get right back in here. Here we go. Got him. Always they are always with the starship every time. Alright, so let's look into how you charge this thing anyway. Well, I have to get out, I guess, to even have that option. Here we go. Alright. Very short amount of time I'm allowed to be out in the open here. So if I want to charge you, I need to use titanium. Do I even have much titanium? Apparently I have some. How do I close this interface? No, well, I mean, just that page. Oh my goodness, that's my entire inventory. Okay. That's not a good start for me. Okay. You can transfer things with X to your starship. Maybe I should do just that. Oh, yeah, it's a trade commodity. Let's get rid of that immediately. Metal alloy. Just gonna get rid of some of the basic ones because we have a fair number, and I can't pick up anything else if I don't get rid of those. What is this? User's able to run for extended periods using iron and carbon. So I can extend my running, but it'll take up a slot of my inventory. Well, there's a crazy thing to think, keep in mind. So I only have 12 slots, and I can sacrifice more slots to make things worse. And my life support's going down, so we better fix that too.
Life support power, low. Technology recharge.
Got it? Alright, we're reasonably alive right now. So, I think I just need to... I'm starting to think that I need to write down like a checklist of things that I want to have to survive, or to craft. Let's see, top priorities here. So we need to build kerite sheets. Kerite sheets are made out of what? Does it say how to make one? Can I click on one to make it? It's just okay. So somewhere out there is a kerite sheet I need to find, probably pre-crafted, I suppose. We need to do the... let's see. We need our pulse engines and thrusters just to be able to function. For those, we need kerite sheets, we need iridium, and we need zinc. People are saying I can pin stuff, but they're not really saying how to pin it, which is the important part of that kind of statement. Or maybe I can only even interact with these things correctly while on the ship. Okay. So if I wanted to repair this... oh, shit. I don't see a way to pin this. I don't... what do I think of this game so far, chat? Really? It's been like a minute. I don't even know what anything is yet. Yeah, I just don't... it doesn't say anywhere on this how to make a kerite sheet, does it? Or how to craft anything? Is there even a crafting menu? They really just dump you in, huh? Alright, well I'm tired of looking at that menu, so I'm just gonna go in a direction again. Okay. We're going down this time. This seems safe. Look at those super... triangular angles around here. Procedural generation! To the massive, immersive, and super believable universe. Oh, that's not how you do that at all. You do not shoot those with lasers, as it turns out. That's how you waste your laser. Nope. You'd be picking our plants, right? Oh, I destroy you. So that was just like a thing growing out of the plant you can pick up. Hey, robot. So he didn't react to me. Good to know. I guess I was startled the first time. But it's okay, no one will ever know about my sins. That's just between you and me. And the rest of the internet. Okay. So I'm anticipating these are probably gonna be like long, hour-long videos where very slow stuff happens, and I don't know. After I get a little more comfortable, I'll probably take questions from chat, and we'll just kind of have discussions about stuff, because I think this is the type of game where you can easily just kind of get sidetracked and talk about other things a bit as you slowly walk around and do things. So it got hot enough? That's interesting.
Extreme night temperature detected.
What?
Temperature levels stabilizing.
Oh, are you? Where's there a heat source around here? I am slightly nauseated by how close to everything. Huh. The FOV doesn't feel good still for some reason. Like, it feels like I'm claustrophobically close to things. So this must be a heat cave. So this thing must somehow generate heat. Because while standing around, there's no temperature problem. But everywhere else, I'm immediately in trouble. Let's see. So I need to figure out how to craft anything ever, first of all. Like, I want a carrot sheet. Is this how you craft things? No, that's my inventory. There's gotta be a crafting menu somewhere, right? I can't be crazy, can I? I am definitely feeling like I'm in over my head already. Cool. I want a carrot sheet. If I want one. So this is just my inventory. So is there a menu where you make things? Presumably I need to make a sheet. I'm not going to pick them up off the ground, right? Like, I'm not gonna just pick up carrot sheets off the ground. Presumably, I would craft them. So is there like another menu I'm missing here? I'm trying here. Okay. Should we go? These are all technology based. Right click doesn't do anything. How do you play this game? All right, if you guys are going to constantly say stuff like, he doesn't pay attention to chat, you think he likes talking to us, he's like all this nonsense, I'm just going to stop streaming. You're just going to make me not want to stream anymore. Because everyone saying acknowledge me over and over again is just really off-putting, especially when I'm just trying to figure out the game that you all want to see me play. Let's see. I get you said click on an empty slot. I did it. That's an empty slot. It's like technology. Look, it says technology. The comments aren't that helpful either. Yeah. Alright. Alrighty then. Click E on an empty slot? What the f- Why is it a different button? Okay, so clicking on an empty slot makes you do a different menu button than E on it. Does it say that anywhere on the screen somewhere? Craft product, there we go. Okay. So that's how you make a carrot sheet. And so for this shit, I need at least four of those. I need six total, looks like. So for the carrot sheets. Oh, I wonder if they stack. They do not stack at all. Okay, good to know. I should probably just head back once I should just make some and craft. Just take them back. They require iron though, so that's a reason to mine iron. There we go. Come on. No, chat, it's a completely unintuitive menu. there's no reason why I would try E or click, really, except for preemptively knowing an empty slot's how you make the item in the first place, I guess, because that's where the prompt kind of shows up. Although you need an empty slot, which I don't have that right now, for example. So you lose access to that kind of information right there. Alright, let's head back to the ship, because I need my extra storage space, because I can only carry, like, 4 objects. Is it warm? No, it's... No, never mind, that's negative degrees. Haha. That's a problem. Let's head on up. So to be fair, when you highlight an empty slot, it does say E to craft. But that's a very specific place to look first to figure out how to craft. It's really weird to not have a crafting menu in a video game about crafting. Or at least like a pop-up saying how to get to the first basic action in the game. As much as I hate pop-up tutorials, they've already established that they exist in this game. And of all things, I think a crafting game is where it becomes pretty necessary. All right, I'm inside the ship now. Right. I could have just sent these to the ship from back there, couldn't I? I actually haven't checked to see if there's a distance for that. Let's see. So to walk you through the process here on PC, you go to the empty slot, you hit E. You then hold down a button on this. For some reason, you have to hold it down, because we're playing Destiny for some reason. Then you have to hit X to transfer to the ship. And you need to do that one at a time, I think. Maybe there's a way to craft more than one. Probably not, just because of the limited inventory space would allow for very limited use of crafting more than one in the first place. Let's get you repaired. There we go! We have a launch thruster! It happened! There we go. So we need iridium and kerite sheet. So I can make one more of those, I'm sure. I just want to click on it. First thing I try to do is left click. There we go. So we have the sheets we need. Now we just need zinc and iridium. Which I found 0 of, that's kind of a big deal. Looks like it's a gas. And I'm not entirely sure how you get gases, if that's the case. We have chrysonite. Cannons. And I need plutonium if I want to have my launch thruster actually work. Do I have that? I actually do. So we're fine from that standpoint. So my big thing I need right now is iridium. There we go. There's a bypass chip. What is this? System hacking device. So we can hijack a landing pad to facilitate alien outposts. Facilities at alien outposts. Perhaps illegal. Yeah. The thing, hacking might be illegal on some level. But we don't have a reason to try that yet. There's got to be a better way to close that menu, right? I'm not crazy. There we go. Right click closes the menu. Clicking off the menu does not close it, which you'd think that'd be what happens, but alright. So I think we're just gonna go on a trip for iridium. Let's see what I want to get rid of in my inventory and just get ready to dump it. Let's see. I'll pop out of here. And I'll look through the stuff I have on my character and repair everything I can. And I'll refill anything I can, and then I'll just get ready to leave. So life charge. Anium, carbon. I'll use carbon for you. So life support's recharged. How's our scanner doing? Carbon, that's not a big deal. And iron. That's two things to repair. We can change our beam. There's a beam intensifier Sigma. Mining beam laser is strengthened by to speed up terrain destruction. Operates automatically once constructed within user's multi-tool. I can afford it. Might as well. Unless the, oh, that's probably a limited slot, isn't it? That could be rough. Combat-focused weapon. Users advise that isotope elements such as carbon are required to recharge device. Use can result in targeted entity death. Well, yeah, that's what guns. That's pretty much the point of those. All right, so we have a gun. We have a gun. Let's refill our mining laser with carbon. And now that everything's refilled, I can probably dump everything in my ship and just start going on a trip to actually pick things up. I'm going back in my ship, not for that, but to actually refill my environmental stuff. Oh, what's going on? Oh, I accidentally left-clicked. Got it. All right, so the starship has all the stuff on it now. And I'm gonna see what I can get done here. And if I'm lucky, maybe I can get some stuff along the way that'll keep me safe. Hopefully, if I'm lucky, I'll get enough resources along the way that I can continually refill my weapon and so on. But honestly, you can't carry much in the first place, so who knows? So how does one find Heridium? So M does not open a map, so it makes me wonder if there's a map in this game to help you try to tell where you are. That's just my history of stuff. We're on a planet. Can I look at the planet? Nope. There's waypoints. Alright. I'm just gonna start walking again. Oh, scan locally with C. Hello. Don't know what a shield means, let's find out. Aha! Are you Heridium? No, you're Chrysonite. That's a gun. I'm stuck on my gun right now. Okay. I don't want to be on my gun. I want to be on my mining laser. And okay, now I'm stuck on my gun. Oh right. X chat says X. Oh thank God. There's a clear benefit to streaming this. Why would you map it to X? Did it say that on the screen somewhere? I wonder if it's, is there just a straight-up controls inventory somewhere? Probably not, I'd say. Nope, here we go. What kind of important stuff can I learn from here, like map? Or strafing? Or interact as E, as you'd expect. T is torch, we have a torch. And a zoom, which is apparently mapped to F. That's a new one for me. Sprint is left shift, as you'd expect. Fire grenade is mouse 3. They mapped grenades to the middle mouse button. Huh. X changes your weapon mode. R is reload. A lot of flight controls. No need to look at those right now. I don't see any mention of a map. H is HUD. That's something. Alright. Hello? Are we friendly? I'm gonna point a torch at you. He doesn't like my torch, apparently. You look awfully interested in me. And he might be less interested in me now? Is he gonna keep following me? Why are you following me a lot? Alright. Well, let's see if I can find something. And maybe he'll, I don't know, respect my boundaries at some point. I'm sure he'll be fine. Oh, hello. That's massively further away than I thought it was going to be. Are any of these waypoints even vaguely nearby? That's... okay. We're going for a trip, damn it. Let's find out what these floating things are. And I can hopefully find stuff that'll keep me warm. Let's remind ourselves exactly what it takes to refill my thermal protection. Zinc, titanium... okay. I'll hope to find exactly those along the way. Oops. Got some isotopes. So we got pieces of blown up ship here. Those might have what we need. A knowledge stone. You learned the Korvac's word for rare. Surprisingly, an uncommon and first thing we found. New technology. Advanced cooling system. Photon cannon cooldown times are significantly reduced. Don't need to go much further than that because we haven't even used a ship yet. So let's not delve too far into the technology I can use on it at this point. So is there a downside to hello. So those must be the isotopes we can use. Hello. So the more you scan, the more it seems to help out, but then it has to recharge. Cargo drop. There we go. Oh. Mixed results, perhaps. Oh, they go away. All the scans go away. I wonder what the point is of making them fade away. Like, does your computer just magically forget about the thing it found already? Oh, that's... Nope, go back to the... Oh, they look the same. That'll be even more confusing. It doesn't change weapons, it actually just changes modes. Alright. Get ready for a long series where the majority of times that I shoot are actually on accident. There's zinc. So we should be good... If I can keep finding those, we'll be good from a heat perspective. And it is falling right now. So let's establish how much I need for that. Right here. Oh, shielding shard. Look at that little bit of convenience right there. The zinc seemed to go a decent way. Let's try pointing straight at that waypoint. It'll take me 3.5 minutes to get to the heridium deposit, and it's exactly what I'm looking for, so I should probably just go for it. No time like the present, right? Are there other waypoints around for that thing? Doesn't necessarily seem like it. Hello. One of those freaky moments where you start losing track of up and down a little bit because of the crazy shape of the crazy non-room shape of the environment. Look at this place. It just stretches. Here we go. I want to know what the shield is. What is that? No pop-up for it? Seems awfully nearby. Oh, I heard almost like a whale call. Hey guys. They're just kind of around. They're making these... What sounds are you making? Weird to identify. Let's see, can I look up you guys up close? I'm supposed to be able to zoom with with mouse 2. Maybe I need to be in gun mode? No. No, F. F then right trigger, there we go. Oh, it's scanning it. Yeah, 200 credits, and really bad performance. There's a treasure chest over here? Ooh, shield at maximum. Treasure chest, where'd you go? There you are. What does this mean? It's just something kind of rare? Emerald? Well, it's mine now, whatever it is. Well, that's a nice looking place. The clusters are kind of all over the place. These red plants. Temperature levels stabilizing. So it's just magically warm inside of caves? Is that what I'm supposed to think? Because that's a hell of a temperature difference. It seems to change temperature by like 40 degrees Celsius between being slightly in a cave and not slightly in a cave. I don't know if I'd buy into that.